Hey everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions once again. How's it going? Hope your day is going well. I do apologize for not having put up a video in a while. Just had some difficulties here, mainly the fact that my eyesight seems to be failing me, and it's getting harder and harder for me to paint. So, I've just kind of taken a break from painting for a little bit, trying to rest my eyes, get them back to where they don't hurt all the time. And things seem to be working out now, so I should be posting up some more videos sometime soon. In the meantime, though, while I'm still recovering, I thought it might be a good idea to tell you where you can find some good tips on how to paint. So, I'm just going to start out with a couple of books here that I just like to run over and just let you see what they are and just give you my opinions on them. So, let me move the figure out of the way. And alright, the first book is this one right here. This is the How to Paint Citadel Miniatures book. I think, if I'm not mistaken, that there might be a newer version of this, because the one that's on the Games Workshop webpage has some sort of an elf right here. It doesn't have the Grey Knight. So this might be an old version. I'm not 100% positive. But doesn't really matter. This book runs for about $20. It's got quite a bit of pages in here, almost 100 pages. Let me back out just a little bit. I don't think anybody's going to care if I show you the inside of the book, so we'll do it anyway. Haha. And essentially, it's going to look like this. I'll be honest with you up front. My personal opinion of this book, it's not a very good book on painting anyway. It's got a lot of stuff in here. It's not very well done, though. It's very poorly organized. Instead of going from a logical painting standpoint of this is what you do when you start painting a miniature, and as they progress through the book, the techniques become more and more advanced, they've come up with this crazy idea where they simply start with the letter A. I don't know if you can see that. There we go. They start with A, and they progress B through C, and they come up with corresponding techniques. So, for instance, A stands for aim, which means what do you want your miniatures to look like, all right? B stands for basic brushwork, black undercoats, blending. You know, it doesn't progress well. C is for color theory. And so, you've got all of these random techniques sort of thrown together, and while it is kind of nice for a beginning painter to where you can see some decent techniques, the painters that they actually got to write this book and to do the examples for this book, not my particular style. I'm not going to say they're not good painters. One of the guys that is in this book is actually Kevin Dollimore, which is one of my favorite painters. But unfortunately, for this particular book and for my style of painting, I really don't enjoy the way that this thing has been done. A lot of this is... It's very haphazardly done. Let me see if I can give you a good for instance. Here we are. Take a look at the face of this dark elf right here. And just see how it's been done. Okay. We undercoat with a dark undercoat. Alright. Then they progress to a slightly lighter shade. And then they come over here and they just kind of throw on some color. There's no real rhyme or reason to it. It doesn't look good at all. And so, but that's the way they tell you to do it. And so to me, for the money, there's a lot better books out there. All right? And so I just, you know, if you're brand new to painting and you're looking for something to get you started, I would not start here. If you're an experienced painter and you want to see the works of some other people and how other people paint, go for it. go ahead and grab this book. It's a good book just to get an idea of what else is out there. But for beginning painters, this is not the place to start, okay? And I know a lot of you guys are going to give me some flack because it's a Games Workshop product, and everybody out there loves Games Workshop except me. So I'll just take it and, you know, I'll deal with it. But instead of this book, however, I would take a look at, as far as current publications go, I would take a look at this book instead. Okay, this is the Foundry Miniatures Painting and Modeling Guide. This is a hardbound book. It's actually done by Kevin Dalimore, one of the guys that wrote part of the other book. But this one is much more well organized. It's got so many beautiful examples of great figures. It starts out with basically how to even set up your painting station. This is a great book for beginners. It even tells you how to sit when you're sitting at your table. I mean, this is it's unbelievable. Nobody I've ever seen has gone into this kind of detail in a book. All right? I've seen some DVDs that are pretty detailed, but this is by far the most detailed book I've ever seen. All right? He takes you from how to paint miniatures using what he calls the one-color method, which is basically putting one color of any of various colors on different parts of your model, what most people would call a base coat. All right, he teaches you how to do it so that it looks good to where you can throw a lot of models out onto a table at one time and get a game going. All right, then he progresses over here to a two-color system later on in the book. All right, and then finally he progresses to a three-color system. And some of these models are just absolutely beautiful. Take a look at this this orc-type model down here. Let me see if I can zoom in on just this face. Is unbelievable. Take a look at that. I mean, that is really impressive, okay? You won't find that in your Games Workshop book that I showed you earlier, all right? A lot of great examples. A lot of really cool miniatures just to look at. Foundry produces a ton of miniatures. And when I say a ton of miniatures, if I had to guess, I would say Foundry's miniature line spans about 1,000 different molds, each with their own individual figure. So we're talking tons of figures, all from various parts of history, from fantasy to sci-fi, pretty much anything and everything you could possibly look for. Now, this book does not come cheap, all right? The other book was 96 pages in total. This one is 177, but you get so much more information. It's hardbound. And it's a fantastic book. It's a great, great purchase for any beginning painter. Now, how much is it? I think, if I'm not mistaken, that I paid $25 for this. I bought this on eBay. I believe Foundry, if you order it directly from them, you have to pay $45 for it. So I got mine for less than half price on eBay. But if you want to order it from Foundry, go to www.wargamesfoundry.com. All right? They got all kinds of miniatures at their website. Go check them out. They're a great company. My only complaint about their company is the bases on their figures. They don't really do anything with bases, but that's cool because their figures look so cool. You can make up your own bases. But anyway, take a look at this. Negate this. Throw this away. I will see if I can find a copy of the, what I think is a newer, revised version of this, the one with the elf on the front. It may be that they used the same book and just slapped a new cover on it. I don't know. But if you have your choice, don't get this. Get this instead. This is a much better book. It's awesome. It's got so many cool tips and things like that in it. So there you go. That's my review on a couple of different books. I hope you enjoyed it. I know it was fast. I know it was haphazard. But I really wanted to throw up a video tonight. So you guys take it easy. Have a great evening. Have a great rest of the day. Whenever you're watching this, man, I hope that everything's treating you well. God bless you, and I'll see you next time.